I got this bicep injury. I ain't playing, man. Well, I wasn't working out per se. I was stretching extra far for the remote. I think I need a cast. Anyway, you know, man, there is so much serious stuff going on out there. And more than that, there's tons of speculation from every direction, left and the right. You know what? Sometimes you just need to shut your pie hole and let the dust settle. Well, that's something I've never been good at, though. Welcome to Intellectual Frog Legs. Now you got impeachment talk heating up, and not just in conservative circles. Good thing we have that safety net in Joe Biden.
The Villages, America's friendliest hometown. The Villages, America's friendliest hometown. The Villages.
You know, I can't even watch the news. I get too mad. I accidentally caught Eric Holder's press conference where he was being questioned about the federal government spying on the Associated Press. And some fruit bat reporter actually asked the question, how does it make you feel? What kind of idiotic question is that? How does it make you feel? I feel like a tree. I feel like a little girl. The government just blatantly violated the holy grail of freedom of speech, freedom of the press, and this so-called journalist cannot come up with a more serious question than, how does it make you feel? Is this some high school newspaper? You know, we need to start like an SST program. Slap, sterilize, and tattoo.
Endless conversations, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less fun, a little less bite, a little more smart. Close your mouth and open up your heart, and maybe satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby.
This is a historic week, and it's not so much of what has happened, but how America responds to such a rogue Marxist government. And that's what they are. But more specifically, not how we're going to respond, but how these violated news organizations are going to respond. A line has been drawn in the sand. And I mean, as a news organization, how is any source going to trust you to talk to you again? I mean, when you're getting your phones tapped by the government. And we're going to see how many journalists actually have a backbone and how many journalists decide to do what's right. And I think there'll be a few. But I promise you right now, it will not be CBS. It will not be ABC, NBC, or CNN. These guys are completely under government control. That's why government didn't have to spy on them. They got an office there. I'm serious. People don't realize how intertwined the Obama administration has become with the major news organizations.
We are family. I got all my sisters with me. We are family.
I mean, these guys can actually have family dinners together, for goodness sake. And all of it's documented. They don't try to hide it. Because, hell, they own most of the microphones anyway. Who's going to tell? We'll start with NBC. Everybody knows that NBC's parent company, General Electric, received $140 billion in stimulus money. $140 billion in stimulus money. That sure stimulated me. How about you? But $140 billion buys you a whole lot of good advertising. I think you get the platinum plan. Anyway, NBC bought and paid for. Now we're going to look at CBS, ABC, and CNN. So get out your interactive family trees. But first, CBS. President Obama's deputy national security advisor, his name is Ben Rhodes. And if that sounds familiar, that's because Ben has a brother named David Rhodes, who's the president of CBS News. Of course, Ben was qualified. You don't just throw somebody in as a deputy national security advisor. What was his qualifications? He has a master's in fiction from NYU. serious. I didn't see that interview. Thank you for coming in, Mr. Rhodes. You're applying for the position of Deputy National Security Advisor. What exactly are your qualifications?
I have a master's degree in fiction from NYU.
Well, what the hell does that mean?
I can make stuff up.
Do I get a badge?
Smith & Wesson, 44 Magnum. Let's see if I can take this bad guy out. That baby will definitely get the job done.
Unfortunately, you've grown up hearing voices that incessantly warn of government as nothing more than some separate, sinister entity that's at the root of all our problems. They'll warn that tyranny is always lurking just around the corner. You should reject these voices.
Government is the problem.
What difference at this point does it make?
Just as the Tea Party movement was gaining steam, a group of IRS specialists were told to focus on organizations with, quote, political-sounding names. Specialists were told to be on the lookout for Tea Party applications, along with groups whose mission was to educate about the Constitution.
But he's using the power of government to investigate his enemies. He's tapping the phones of the press.
You know, we love to mock the Tea Party, saying they have tinfoil hat conspiracy theorists. This time it looks like they're right.
Government is the problem.
Anyway, CBS, you gone too. Now let's zip over to ABC. Their news president, his name is Ben Sherwood. Ben Sherwood. I think he has a cousin named Forrest. No time for joking. But what we do know is Ben's sister, Elizabeth, is special assistant to Barack Obama.
If a picture paints a thousand words, then why can't I paint?
That covers the big three, ABC, CBS, and NBC. Now let's scooch over to CNN. Their deputy bureau chief, Virginia Moseley, she's married to a dude named Tom Nides, deputy secretary of state under Hillary during the Benghazi massacre.
This is both an ongoing matter and an ongoing matter about which I know nothing. I don't know what has happened in this matter.
I did not know. I assume he was, but I don't know. And I don't know what you are going to ask. I did not know. I don't know. I don't know what happened. That I don't know. I don't know why that didn't happen. I simply don't have a factual basis to answer that question. I don't know. Good question, and I'm not sure what the answer is. Don't remember that, though. I'm not sure. I don't remember when that happened. I'm not even sure I remember. And I'm just not sure exactly when that happened. I think we're going to have to get into the investigation before I can answer that question more intelligently. That I'm not sure. I just don't know. Do you know that? I'm not aware of that. I'm not sure about that. I have no knowledge of that has ever occurred. I simply don't know. I'm not sure exactly. I'd have to go back and look. I don't know. I was recused.
I recused myself.
What day did you recuse yourself?
I'm not sure. I don't know exactly when. I'm not sure. Nothing immediately comes to my mind. I'm not aware of that.
I just don't know what the statistics are. I'm unaware. I don't know what happened. I don't know exactly. I don't know the specific questions. I know.
Well, either you know or you don't know.
You cannot know what I know. That's all.
I love this. A report just came out. Of course, it was reported by the BBC. The United States supply of shale oil is massive. So massive, it could shift the global balance of power. Well, we already know we have massive coal supplies. But the problem is we have a federal government that blocks us from using our own resources. You know, we could solve a lot of problems if we get the federal government out of the way. If I were governor of one of these fossil fuel producing states, I would openly defy the feds, and I would, and hopefully set the stage for a big 10th Amendment showdown. Federal government's out of control. I'm from the hills of Kentucky. If I was the Kentucky's governor, I'd tell the feds, hey, look, we're going to start mining. We're going to start mining our coal. Now, you go right ahead and file whatever lawsuits you want to file and do all your things, but you'll do that after you get your ass out of our way. And by the way, once we get started and we catch any of your EPA guys running around here, we're going to arrest them. But see, your federal regulations against coal unfairly punish and burden American citizens that live in coal-producing states, while having no effect on the livelihoods of folks in like New York or D.C. or California. Coal is our lifeblood. Coal is our economy, and our people are hurting, and we don't give a damn what a bunch of you tree-hugging fruit bats in Washington, D.C. think. I tell you what, when you sons of bitches pass laws that California can't use their ocean, that's getting awful polluted, then we'll consider not using our resources. But in the meantime,
well, it's a great day for me to whoop somebody's ass.
About it, you know, I hope you guys were mindful of federal regulations. Oh, somebody go un-gag that liberal over there. Anyway, quickly, I want to revisit Obama's comment to ignore voices that warn against government tyranny.
You should reject these voices.
He does not say make them prove it. He does not say study it for yourself. He does not say look at the track record, because he does not want you looking at historical facts. He has no leg to stand on. You know what I would tell those kids? Reject no voice. Just make them prove it. Kind of like what Reagan said, trust but verify. But Captain Destructo here, he's like, well, trust me. You know, if socialism worked, they wouldn't have to cheat. Well, before we go, one of the greatest movie scenes ever, a true cinema masterpiece, Bruce Willis hitting golf balls at a bunch of left-wing fruit bats. Four.
I'm ready for it. Rise and shine!
Thank you guys so much for being here. I know you couldn't help notice my snazzy red Frogleg University shirt. And of course, this handsome style. Truly spiffy.
Every girl crazy about it, shine as me.
Anyway, got links over at the website. There's also links to get these bullet necklaces for under 10 bucks. Please stop by the website, intellectualfroglegs.com. Sign up for the show alerts. There's also links there to hook up with me on Facebook and Twitter. And thank you for the awesome PayPal donations. We also take checks, too. But Frog Legs are free to watch, but they're not free to make. And, you know, I've been telling you guys, we've been having some technical issues. This ain't no joke. The blue screen of doom tells no jokes. Anyway, everything you need is over the website. Please share the videos with your friends. Use force if necessary. Keep those disconnected comments and all capital letters coming, you left-wing, gender-neutral bichachos.
What you feel? You walked right into the trap.